Since last time, this made some changes to the organizational room. I put stairs up here only because I wanted to have a chest up here for my hopper thing, just to make it easier to smelt some stuff. Boop, boop, boop. Yep. Another update. I made stairs that go up. I'm not super in love with them. I might change them up later, but I think it's okay for now. Like last time, I need to make a sword. So I've been a little lost, a little off the path because I don't really have a solid next goal to go towards. So I was thinking I could go down and set up that zombie grinder down there. Don't have anything really to upgrade, but pain of arthropods. So I'll take it. Whatever. There's lapis in here. I didn't even need to go all the way up there. Got another portal, enchantment table, whatnot, blah blah blah. Yeah, let's head down there and do that. I should probably sleep first. And empty out my inventory. Just gonna fling this stuff in here. This will be like my ongoing project chest, or just a dump chest, I guess. I also want to build something with this zombie grinder. I'm not sure what. I was thinking like a underground cathedral type of thing. Not a big one, you know. Just stylize it a little bit. Put like an underground church or like pillars or something over here. Unexplored cave. I did explore that actually, so I'm going to take that off. I think I want to get some tinted glass. How do I make tinted glass? I have to Google it. I need to find a geode for that, so that's going to have to wait. And it's convenient that we have a zombie grinder because in that village over there, there was a cleric that trades for rotten flesh. And I say grinder. I use the word grinder and spawner interchangeably. Because if you find a spawner, you turn it into a grinder. Otherwise, what's the point? While I dig this out, I want to talk about some stuff. I started my job. Lowe's Fulfillment Associate, one of the internet order guys. Get the orders in, do it. It's not glamorous, or much, but you gotta do what you gotta do. It does remind me how much I despise capitalism, you know, as every good, you know, person should. So I just want to remind you, if you also hate capitalism, go out of your way to, like, you know, next time it's convenient. Not necessarily go out of your way, but next time it... fuck, I can't talk. Next time it's convenient, just go ahead and tag your local Walmart. So why not? Yeah, capitalism sucks. And a lot of people think it's like the government. The government are the ones you need to look out for. They're the ones out to get you. But the government, it's just kind of here because it has to be. And they're doing stuff for sure. There's no way they're not fucking, like, I don't know, doing human experiments or something. But the real enemy, the real ones you gotta look out for, are the corporations, because those are the guys who make money off of you and who need you. Colleges, you go to college, go to school for 4 years just to get a degree to work in a very specific job that only exists because a corporation made it. So you start a career there. You don't go to college anymore to better yourself, to gain knowledge about the world or whatever. You go to college, so you can get a career and go work at a corporation and make them money. You get paid, you're making money, but not as much as them. So it sucks. And that's just how it be, you know? So if you're feeling a little, you know, anarchy, a little, I need to go out there and do something, go tag your local Walmart or something. Unless you like that Walmart. Don't tag that Walmart if you like it. But if you don't like that Walmart, go put a word on it or something. Don't put something like a dick. You don't want to put like a penis because that's just distasteful. Put something artsy on there. Something that looks nice. They have to get rid of it no matter what it is, but you flex on them. Shoot. They know they're getting flexed on. That's all that matters, right? You can go with like a word. One of my favorite words, and I think it applies to, you know, most people's situation within the society. The word solace. Definition is comfort or consolation in time of distress or sadness. That's the noun, and the verb is give comfort or consolation to. And it definitely would comfort me to see a giant spray paint on the side of a Walmart, because I fucking hate super centers. I hate supermarkets. I don't like them. It's the only type of store that's around here, or a strip mall. The only strip mall I want to see is a type of strip mall, the one that's got the same vibes as Friends vs. Friends. I got a video of that coming out here soon, or before this, I don't know. But that game's pretty. I enjoy it. Alexa, turn off Julia. Yeah, but that game is pretty, and it's fun too. It can feel a little unfair, but I'm sure they're working out the kinks. For the zombie grinder, I'm kind of just doing a basic design. I remember for a while that didn't work anymore, but I think at least in 1.19 this worked. So this episode, I guess, zombie grinder, next episode, villagers? If not villagers, I guess I'll get it, like, I'll use this to grind out a good pickaxe, and then I'll collect resources to build up that village. Because I don't want to make a villager breeder, because they're depressing. They depress me, because the villagers have to sit in there, and it makes me sad. And this is my single-player world, so I don't have to min-max everything. I just want to enjoy it, you know? I really don't like the people who feel the need to min-max it. Min-max whatever they do. Fucking video game, reading a book, fucking buying a house, shoot. I mean, there's advantage to it, but just fucking enjoy your life, man. You can play casually in video games. I'm a staunch defender of casual gaming. Gaming is for everybody. And if you want to get in Hypixel and play Bed Wars, you shouldn't have to be stomped by some fucking Technoblade fanboy. Technoblade, rest in peace. But you know what I mean. I like Technoblade. I'm just being a little crass right now. Rest in peace, my boy. Don't like Dream. Don't hate me for saying that. But do 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 do. I like this too, because it's already pre-dug out. I'll just connect these two together, and then you can have a fucking walkway. Dude, this is perfect. Shit is perfect. I have to get more water. Ooh, I got mossy cobble now. I'm going to place that around. Yeah, this. Just got to dig through here for a sec. Look, that's just great. I love that. Maybe I'll use diorite, however the fuck you want to say it. What can we, like, put some lore around a zombie spawner? Like, what I want to do in here is make a giant smuggler's den. Just, like, fucking barrels and shit everywhere. Or, like, a catacomb. Both. Like, depths, there's a catacomb, and then the top is, like, a big old smuggler's den. It's both. It was first the catacombs, and then the smuggler found it. Smugglers found it. They turned it into a den. Go up here and get some water. Make another bucket real quick. I like that birch tree. If it's a catacomb, then yeah, I'm gonna build a church type thing. I don't know about a church. At least, like, I don't know, pillars. I'll put pillars here, and there'd be like tinted glass, and then like a, I don't know. I'll have to figure out. I'm sure I'll put like a sped up time lapse of it, and you guys will see me building it. Because the way I build, it can be frustrating to watch, I think. It's not concise, it's not planned out. I kind of just fuck around and find out until I like it. Sometimes I don't even like it. Sometimes I'm like, that's a placeholder until I know what I want. Like the stairs over there. Ooh, speaking of the stairs, let's put this. I like to think of these stairs as, I like to think that they were here before this tower. Or there was like an older tower before it. That's what I might do down there. Put like a little tower ruin around it. Put something like right there. Hey, buddy. Can go to sleep. I needed one more water, didn't I? Bloop. Such a cute village. What's up, doggies? I need to give them names. I don't have enough name tags yet. And I also got a name tag Pastor Chrome Dome in there. So in Minecraft modded, there is always like limestone from some sort of mod. Great fucking cork or some shit. And I always like that color. And I wish... Got him! Ooh! Killed that motherfucker. There's been a fly who's been landing on me since I got home from work today. It's pissing me off, but I just fucking smacked the shit out of him. Didn't even think about it. I feel at peace now. Greatest enemy has been slain. Before I go down there, let's just boop, boop. I do want to get the tinted glass, but I gotta find a geode first, and that might be a struggle. That might be a whole episode unto itself, a search for a geode. Let's get in there. I should survive that. Cool. It's like 21 blocks, right? I'm gonna count. I'm not gonna use coordinates. I'm gonna count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. All right, it's too far. 20? I'm waiting for it to spark back up. Goddamn. You're just not sparking? There we go. So that's the level we gotta be at. I really like this fucking outcrop that we got here. Just a naturally made tunnel straight to where we want the zombie spawner to be. I wonder if I could do something silly where I just leave it open and let them fall, just bonk, or if they would like hit an edge of the block or something. I'm not gonna risk it. But I am gonna take out this here just to even it out. Shit, I'm getting fucking bombarded. I don't have any arrows. Really need to get like a stack of arrows from a Fletcher. You fucked up. You shouldn't have missed. Would have been really clutch if this was a skeleton spawner. But gotta work with what you got. And we're lucky enough to have this here. You know, I'm thinking about it and I kind of feel bad for killing the fly. You know, just taking a life so mercilessly. Instantly. It's kind of fucked up. And I'm kind of sad about it. I don't know why I just opened my inventory so many times. I don't know what I was doing. So I want him to fall as far as possible so I don't have to hit him as many times. Did they change the distance? I feel like... do this. Gotta have it at least like that. Let's go up, use the stone cutter, get a slab. Get some slabs. There's a ghost squid that just fucking committed. It's a fucking cool ass cave. My favorite part is this island over here. It juts off and then it goes up higher. I'm gonna need more of this. I like that it's a little bit longer, a longer walkway. There's baby zombies and shit. So, like that? I don't know if I want it like that. Like that, that's better, I think. And then we can get some stairs to go around there. But I think I want to do that, diorite design. I can live with that. Collect more of this. I don't want to shave too much off of here because it'll fuck up the way the cave looks. Should have just brought the stone cutter with me. I'll go ahead and do that next this time. Maybe I'll cut out these two walls and then I'll put quartz pillars. I think that would look cool. And maybe I'll replace the blocks up here with quartz. But for right now, we're going to just do alright. This is what we got. Diorite. I don't know how the fuck you say it. My dog barking. What the dog barking? This should be a functional grinder. Final step to making a grinder. Sometimes it could be the risky part if you're uncalculated. Which I pretty much usually am, but this is my strat for doing it. Fuck. Oh, I need one more thing. I need a slab for the top so nothing spawns. I don't know if that's a thing. I don't know if it's still a thing. Saw it in the video, so I'm gonna do it. All right. Fuck you, zombies. Yeah, I don't know how to get them to one hit. I'll just have to get like Smite 5 sword or something. But yeah, we got a zombie grinder now, y'all. That's enough to get us a solid pickaxe. Start working on some builds. Also, if anyone cares, let me know if you want me to fight the Ender Dragon, because I'm okay with not doing that for a while. Not that I'm scared or anything. I'm not shivering me timbers. But, once you get Shulkers and Elytras, the game is different. I enjoy in-game, because you can focus on a lot more, but right now I'm okay with just using my shitty enchants, building with what I got. I enjoy that part of Minecraft, and I'd like to savor it. I'd also have to go light up all these caves so I can get better mob spawns out of this. But XP farm. Really easy. I've memorized it. There's been many a times where I've either someone on my team or me has been a little dumb, a little stupid, and you literally get your cords leaked or somebody gets to your base somehow and they just fucking blow your shit up, so now you gotta leave. Find a grinder, grind out gear again, you know, it's just the whole fucking Minecraft survival cycle, which I like that. Like I said, Minecraft, true Minecraft survival, every player should have a chance to be destroyed or prosper, you know? And you need a healthy balance. If you're never destroyed, then you never prosper. I don't know if that makes sense. Good to sweet. Finally nice to have like a consistent food source. Also, I have an idea for sheep barn. Let me get this wheat real quick. 30 minutes, goddamn, that's how long this took. So what I was thinking of doing up here, I have these sheep. I was thinking of like digging into this hill here and just making an every color sheep farm. And just line them up on either side. I don't know if that would be cool. Or if like you guys would prefer I make a super complicated redstone sheep farm. I've always kind of wanted to make one of those. Actually, I'm kind of convincing myself right now in the moment to do that. So I guess we're doing that instead. I don't know if it'll be here. It'll definitely be when I fucking need wool, which I kind of do. I kind of do need some wool. Here, let me show you why. Today at work, you know, Donovan came over last night. Donovan's my friend. And I'm going to play you the clip, but I'm from home from work and he put this on my computer. Because I asked him, Donovan. I called him at work and I was like, it would be cool if you got on my computer and built something in my world for everyone to see. And he was like, I'll just play the clip for you. But yeah, go ahead and sub to him if you want to. He's got some videos. He's got some videos. Go ahead and give him a watch. It's the Lorax. I want to get this guy in the world. I think next episode I'll work on getting the stuff I need to build him and put him in the survival world. Yeah, I'm going to play the clip down and recorded. And that's all, guys. Bye.
Hello, it is I, Enemy Jekyll. I was trying to take Super Creature's World and add stuff to it, but it doesn't have cheats on, so I'm going to build it here. Oh, it's the first thing you see, so I'll put it in the tree. Even though what I'm building would be mad I'm doing this. Okay, how do I start this? Oh, sorry. Trusty hands on my fitness. He is the Lorax, and he speaks for the trees. If you don't listen to him, he'll break your knees. It's one of these two. I can't remember which one, but it's one of them.